I don't know what he's doing for you, but for me, my mourning, my crying day, I would not be unto the residue of this people as the former days, said the Lord of hosts. For the seed shall be prosperous. Y'all ain't shy.
Ho!
He said, in other words, I'm not going to do what I did to those prior to them. Residue is what? What is left over? Which is considered what? Remnant.
Okay.
He said, but now I will not be unto the residue of this people as in the former days, saith the Lord of hosts. For the seed shall be prosperous, the vine shall give her fruit, and the ground shall give her increase, and the heaven shall give her due, their due. And I will cause the remnant of this people to possess all things. God said, glory to God, the Lord said, hallelujah, that my sowing in faith was not in vain. Are you hearing me? He said, I'm not going to do what I did before. I consider you to be the residue. I consider you to be the remnant, and I'm going to cause you to possess all things. I'm going to cause your mind to prosper. I'm going to cause the heaven to give its due. I'm going to cause the land to increase for you. Who am I talking to in here? I'm just keeping on this word. I'm just believing this word. When he gave me this word, I said, God, I thank you. He said, daughter, your sowing in faith has not been in vain. The same year, 100-fold, and the Lord blessed him. When going to greatly bless you. So you're going to find that the God.
Come on here.
Well, I found it. Amen. You ain't got to worry when it's time. When you have need for it, it's going to show up.
Yeah.
It's going to show up. It got to show up. Go to the book of Ruth chapter 2 verse 11 and we're done. There's two more scriptures and we're done. Ruth chapter 2 verse 11. Are you hearing me? And Isaac what? Sowed. He what? Scattered his seed. Are you hearing me? And in that same 7 year he what? Received or he found 100-fold. Are you hearing me? Everything that we do, everything that we say is a what? A seed. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Wow. Ruth chapter 2 and verse 11. Watch scripture. And Boaz answered and said unto her, it has fully been shown me all that thou hast done unto what? Your mother-in-law. It has fully been shown me. You sowed a seed. You sowed a seed by what? Helping her. Ruth chapter 2 and verse, glory to God, verse 11. You was doing, you was helping her. That was what a seed form. It was showed to us. Are you hearing me in here?
Yes.
Are you hearing me in here?
Oh, yeah.
All that thou hast done unto your mother-in-law since the death of thy husband, and how thou hast left thy father and thy mother and the land of thy nativity, in other words, where you were born, and are come unto a people which thou knewest not heretofore. Are you hearing me? Your seed is manifesting. Your seed, glory to God, is not going unrewarded. It is going to be rewarded. Go into Ruth chapter 3. Ruth chapter 3. I want you to see this. Glory to God. Verse 10. And he said, blessed be thou of the Lord, my daughter, for thou hast shown more kindness in the latter end. In other words, you didn't stop. You could have stopped. You could have changed. Because right. You got to drive.
Right.
You could have started acting funny.
That's it.
But you didn't. Come on, somebody. Don't start changing when God starts blessing you. Wow. Don't start acting funny when things start all coming your way.
Yes.
Things start lining up. He said to her, in the latter end, you didn't even change.
Yes.
Lord, have mercy.
Yes.
You stayed the same when you didn't have nothing. You still was a giver when you didn't have nothing.
Yes.
You still being kind to people when you didn't have nothing. Glory to God, you were still helping people. You were still saying kind words to people. Glory to God, you did not change. Because your life got better than your beginning.
Come on,
you showed more kindness in the latter end than at the beginning, inasmuch as thou followest not your man. In other words, you didn't turn, you didn't change. Your heart didn't change. Your mind didn't change. You weren't perpetrating. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You didn't change if they were poor or rich. You didn't have no respect to person. You were just what? Having the seed of righteousness. You had the seed of help. You had the seed of hope. You had the seed of love. You had the seed of giving. You had the seed of Messiah. You had the seed of caring. Glory to God.
Yeah.
think about this no more. But be ye glad and rejoice forever in that which I create. For behold, I create Jerusalem a rejoicing and her people a joy. God's been saying, he said it's time to rejoice. It's time to be glad. It's time to be happy. Well, are you hearing me? Yes. God said, I'm not going to allow you to remember that. If you keep pondering on, I'm going to let you have what you're pondering on. He said, but I'm not going to allow you to remember, glory to God, the form of things, what you've been going through. I'm getting ready to write that out. I'm getting ready to write it out of your mind. We're not thinking about the old thing we're talking about today. Verse 19, and I will rejoice in Jerusalem. So God said, when you get the rejoicing, he's going to come in and rejoice what? In you. And joy in my people. And the voice of weeping shall what? Be no more heard in her. Nor the voice of crying is not going to be in you. God can't be in you and crying in you. And it's going to work.
Come on here.
21, and they shall build houses and inhabit them. And they shall plant vineyards and eat the fruit of them. They shall not build and another inhabit. Somebody better shout right here. God said, I'm not going to allow you to build and then somebody else come in. Glory to God. That's what he's saying. Hallelujah. They shall not build and another inhabit. They shall not plant and another eat. For as the days of a tree are the days of my people, and my elect shall long enjoy the work of their hands. Who am I talking to right there? Verse 23, they shall not labor in vain nor bring forth for trouble.